Well, today is a good day. For those of you that are new to the channel, about a week and a half ago, I damaged my reel mower. I bounced it off some concrete that was in the driveway, damaging the bed knife, completely destroying the reel in the process, so it had to go in for repair. So I reached out to the nice people at Jerry Pate, called up Joey, said, Joey, I got a problem. I broke my mower. I gotta get it back. We're getting into the mowing season. I can't be down. So he was able to fit me in. And if you guys are interested in finding out what all the repairs, everything I had done cost me, be sure to stay to the end of the video because I'll talk to you guys about that. So while the mower was in, something that came to mind was, you know, my mower is a 2014. It came with the 8-blade reel. And all that worked really well on my lawn. I cut with it all last season, did a great job. An 11-blade reel, given my height of cut, would be just about perfect. So according to Toro's documentation, the 11-blade reel is good for cutting heights of 1/4 inch up to 3/4 inch. And right now I'm mowing my lawn right at 1/2 inch. So the bench height is set to 0.495, so it's cutting it just under 1/2 inch. So when I got the mower back last night, what I did was I mowed, because I just had to, and got the new mower back, got to do that. And then this morning I woke up super early and mowed the entire lawn again. So what you're seeing here is the results of the lawn being cut twice with a new reel upgrade. So right now I'm running an 11-blade reel, and guys, I'm not sure if the camera's doing this justice, but if you look in here, look at how tight that is. I mean, that is nice and clean. And as far as compared to the 8-blade, it's definitely a cleaner cut. It does a really, really good job. Now, the reel that I'm running is one of the Edge Series reels. So I guess whenever my mower came out in 2014, that really wasn't even a thing. But since then, Toro's made some adjustments to the reels as far as the upgrades, as far as the materials, the geometry to produce a better cut. And true to form, it definitely does cut better. I'm super happy with the results I'm getting out of it. I mean, I cut the back lawn, side lawn, and swale area, no problems, no issue with scalping, no issue with bogging. It just does a beautiful, beautiful job. So 8-blade was good, 11-blade is definitely better. So now for the part you guys really came here for, and that is, what did it cost me to get it fixed? Now, before I go into that, remember, this mower, even though when I got it, I paid right around $3,000, $3,500 thereabouts for it. But these mowers are brand new. They're $10,000 piece of equipment. So when you get it fixed, even though you're paying whatever you happen to pay for one, I hear people that get these things for, you know, under $1,000, you're still buying a piece of equipment that when new was $10,000. So the parts, the labor, everything associated with a precision piece of equipment like that, it's gonna cost a little bit more. So now for the bill. So when they had the mower, they put a new reel in it, new bed knife, obviously, new bolts, oil, new bearings, seals. I had them change a belt for me, do some other adjustments. All of that for a grand total of $882.96. Yikes. Long short of the story is, don't try to mow concrete with your reel mower.